Hello, Jenny Hall here of Scrappiness. For today's project, I'll be using the Leafy Stencil in the Little Birdie Stamp Set from Ink on 3 and the Slimline Never Ending Dies from Cat Scrappiness. I've die cut every other die so that I can have a larger panel. If I were to use every single die, it would make me have a very thin and narrow panel. So in order to get some more bold colors, I've used every other one. I'll be using some Atelier inks from Ink on 3 and adding color in two different blues for my background. This card is a really fun background process. And then there's some really great watercoloring as my foreground. And so the video is a little bit longer, but I thought you would really enjoy seeing the process. So to create this really fun background, I'm taking those dies and die cut from 110 pound cardstock, and every other rectangle is colored peacock blue, and then the ones in between are Trinity teal. So the blue and the teal colors are going on really heavy and being very concentrated. I'm making sure that I give this a lot of color, because I want the color to come back up and lighten up significantly in a few areas. So there's a couple of different ways we use this stencil. First one is to take a damp paper towel, spritz it with water, you know, just get it nice and wet, and dab up some of the color through the stencil, and that's going to leave me with darker areas that have the stencil design. Or you can spray directly on the cardstock paper, as you see here, and that's going to get more water on that paper, and then dab it up with a drier paper towel. The inks from Ink on 3, that is the Atelier inks, are water reactive, so they are going to come up a little easier than maybe some other inks would, and they leave a beautiful design behind. Now I've sprayed some more water and just tried to get a lighter shade of blue going here, and it worked out perfectly. Our background's almost finished. I couldn't resist using some liquid pixie dust, and I'm putting it through that stencil in order to keep some areas with less splatter than others. The background, when the card is dry and finished, is very, very shiny in certain spots. And it just came out so beautiful. The leafy pattern of the stencil is so pretty, and it just shows through so nicely. So it's a really dimensional background. Now I'm going to create the pieces for the foreground, and this is a new stamp set from Ink on 3 called Little Birdie. And if you follow my channel, you know that I have a weakness for bird stamps. I'm a big fan of birds and bird watching, and this is now my new favorite stamp set. I've stamped it onto watercolor paper with blackout ink, and blackout is a hybrid ink that's from Ink on 3. It's good for alcohol markers or for watercoloring. After I stamped it, while the ink was still wet, I sprinkled on some clear embossing powder, and I heat set it so that it will help me to set my images easier for watercoloring. I have a porcelain palette here that I'm just putting a drop of the ink refills. These are the Atelier inks, and I've shaken the bottle really well first. These are not dye inks, and so it's not just like colored water. There's chemicals in here that need to be shaken up, so make sure that you shake your ink refills really well. I'll be doing some super simple watercoloring, but I can't make it so simple that I don't let this stamp set really shine through. But it is going to be simple enough, I think, that you'll have no trouble following along. First thing I'm doing is flooding the image with some water. Once the image is watered, then I can easily bring some of that ink refill, or you can call it liquid watercolor, and bring it with my wet brush over to the image. Now, when the paint or the ink hits the water, it dilutes and the water pulls it around. And you can see on the bird's chest, I didn't color that center section at all. Instead, I went around the outside edge with the yellow, and you can see that reaction that it had with the water, and just kind of left a natural looking white area at the breast of the bird. And I love that it worked out that way. Sometimes it doesn't, but that's the thing with easy watercoloring, is it just kind of, a lot of it is up to chance. And you can see here that I'm just kind of putting on that color real sloppy, or putting the water on sloppy. And then the same thing for dropping in the liquid watercolor. I'm just like popping it in there and letting it do its own thing. And that's one of my favorite things about watercoloring, is that it doesn't have to be perfect and planned. It looks really pretty when you just kind of let nature take its course. And I'm going to add this yellow to the outside edge, just like I did on the bird. And this is a wet image as well. And on the opposite end of the petal, I'm placing some of that really beautiful red color. I want the flowers to stand out very strongly from the background. Now remember, our background has a lot going on. It's really pretty blues and it's got texture and shine. So I want these images to really be able to be seen and be super bold in order to compete with that background. But it all comes together in the end. Now I'm just taking a wet paintbrush. You see the paints are off the table now, they're gone. And I'm using just a wet brush and then dabbing it off on my dry cloth and kind of letting the colors mix around a bit more. Moving on to our second panel of colored images, I'm going to color the flower buds and the small flower the same way. And I am adding the exact same colors. I'm also adding in to it just a little bit of the pink. One of the new ink colors from Ink on 3 is Sweet Petunia Pink. And it works out really well paired with the red. It just like, it's a natural blend from the red to the pink. I'm coloring the leaves in the same way. First, putting down a layer of water, then adding yellow to the tips, green to the base of the leaf, and then just kind of dotting on a little bit of the orange in the between area and letting it mix together naturally. Moving on to the little twig and berries, I've wet the image, and because it is heat embossed, the color is going to stay right there in that area. And it does, it works out perfectly. Now I'm going to go back and color in that branch that I forgot to color in the first time. And I will make sure that these images are nice and dry before I cut them out. There's not a coordinating die set yet. You could use your scan and cut for these, or if you're like me, then you really like to fussy cut. I'm going to cut my card base for this card. This is a slimline card, and I cut my card bases to 7 inches by 8.5, and I score it at the 3.5 inch mark. After it's scored, I'm going to use a panel. And this is a piece that was left over from cutting the card base, because it ends up being just the right size. And I'm going to lay those pieces that were die cut with the cat scrappiness die right back in there. What I really like about the die set from Cat Scrappiness is that this is a really good sized frame, or a good sized slimline rectangle. But there are, remember, I didn't use every single one. I did every other die. And so it's a really versatile set. In fact, it's so versatile that I used the smallest die in the set in order to cut the sentiment, which is, I'm going to show you that coming up on camera soon. Seeing different ways to use a die set is always inspiring for me in my crafting. So I'm going to take this panel, remember this one is 3.5 by 8.5, and place it on my folded card base, and there is a really nice strong card. Now I'm going to take those fussy cut images and use a black long tipped marker along the edge to make sure that I didn't get any areas when I fussy cut that stayed a little bit more white than they should have. I'm going to place some of the different die cuts around, and there's that gorgeous little bird. I just love that little bird. So be on the lookout for lots more projects with this stamp set. It's called Little Birdie. And there's no coordinating dies, so you can stamp it directly down to a card and color it on your card, or do like me and fussy cut. I noticed that there were a few areas that ended up drying white on the flower, so I pulled that palette of watercolors back out and filled that back in with a wet brush. Now I'm using that same blackout ink, but on a piece of 80-pound cardstock, so this is a much lighter weight. And here is that littlest die from Cat Scrappiness. And look at it. It's perfect. It's perfect for little, thin sentiments. I think I'm going to end up pulling this out quite often. I'm going to fussy cut around the larger word, and that way it's going to be an image that kind of stands out. Usually you'll see me going with black cardstock with white embossing, but I thought if I did it the opposite way, it would stand out a bit more with all this busy background. Now you can check out, I'm adding those little berry twigs and setting them around the sentiment, and it's all coming together. What do you think? I would love to hear your thoughts if you like this background method. This is maybe a new technique for you, and if you like this image. Thank you so much. And don't forget to go over to my blog and comment, and go over to Instagram and comment for your chance to win on this collaboration with Ink on 3 and Cat Scrappiness, a blog hop that is for Happy Harvest. Thank you so much for spending time with us today.